several emails from readers asking me about our homeschool curriculum, how I chose it, how I found it, and what I think of it so far. And I figured it's almost the end of February, so I feel like I know whether or not the curriculum was successful for Isabella and for our homeschool experience so far. So I thought I would kind of do a vlog about that and give you guys a little information. So you mamas who are new to homeschooling would, you know, have at least our experience with the curriculums we chose. I went into our homeschooling journey knowing absolutely nothing about homeschooling. I was a teacher for just a couple years before in the public school system, but other than that, I knew nothing about homeschooling, how it even worked, or how to find curriculum. So I had to do a lot of research on my own. And I did go to several homeschooling conferences. I went to one prior to doing Ella's preschool year, and then I went to two this last spring prior to Ella's kindergarten year. I loved going to the curriculum fair at these conferences because I got to hold the curriculum and see what all the manipulatives were, and I got to figure out whether I felt like those curriculums were going to fit her personality and my personality, and what supplemental tools I was going to need and what ones I could leave out and not have to spend money on. So it was very helpful. I really recommend getting your hands on curriculum before you buy it, even if you just have someone who comes in, a salesman for a curriculum company, come, you know, sometimes they go from town to town and you can go and look at the curriculum that way. You just have to find an avenue in order to get your hands on some curriculum if it's not something that you've ever been exposed to, like it was for me. So I knew that I wanted for phonics and math to have a curriculum that was a little more advanced, simply because I was insecure with my ability to teach phonics and math at such a young age. I was certified first through sixth, so I've never had any experience for pre-K or early childhood type teaching. And so I wanted to make sure that we were right on track with where Ella needed to be for the school year. And so I chose Abeka for phonics this year for kindergarten. We did it for preschool last year, and it was perfect. She really liked it, and it just fit her personality, and it worked good with my personality. So that's what we are doing for phonics this year. She's doing a first grade curriculum for phonics. She's in kindergarten. But she just did so well with the curriculum last year during preschool and just flew through it. So we just bumped ahead to first grade, and it's gone really, really well. Now, sometimes with this curriculum, it's a little confusing. It took me several weeks to really get the hang of the teacher's manual and what I could leave out, and because there's a lot. They want you to get through a lot. And it just wasn't gonna work for us. It just was too much, and some stuff was unnecessary. So that's just for my child. Now, for other children, it might have been perfect, but for Ella, she didn't need to do everything they asked her to do. And so I found a method that works for me, and this is just how I do it. For each little lesson, they have you do, you know, the teacher has to write stuff on the chalkboard, and I just use a piece of paper and write it in pink because she likes pink. And she just does all of her work on this little piece of paper for our phonics lesson. And you have to use charts, so I just pull out the charts that I need and I just stick it in the book and the teacher's manual the day before, and then I'm ready to go. And it's super simple, and I underline things that I want to do and put little boxes around things that I need. I don't know if you can see that. That is how it works for me to keep things organized for myself. And that way I don't have to read every word. I can just go and skim, you know, look at what I need, grab what I need and go. And it doesn't take very long for the phonics lesson. I mean, 10, 15 minutes for the phonics lesson. So that's pretty reasonable. Now we start off her phonics with charts. We have a basic phonics CD, and she and Liam and even Gwyneth get on the floor and do their charts, and these just help her to practice and work on any special sounds that she might need, things that don't necessarily, she can't necessarily sound out, and don't follow typical, you know, rules. So she does that. She starts out with that for phonics. Then we go on to our phonics lesson that I teach her. And then she does her letters and sounds workbook pages. And we just flip through. I have it tagged. And then she flips through and does the page that we're on for that day. It says at the bottom the lesson that she's ready for. And so this is kind of some of her previous work that she's done. So that's how she does that. That is our phonics. So that's a Becca. And for math, we did a Becca last year for preschool for math. And I liked it. But I happened to take a look at Horizons, and for some reason I felt like it was super, a very well-rounded curriculum, and I just really liked it. I liked what they taught, the format they used, and so we use Horizons Math. This is the second workbook, and it just practices addition, even in odd numbers. It's super easy for her to navigate. She started to do her own, read the directions on her own, because she's gotten really, really good at reading. And she's a very independent little girl, so she really likes to, her workbook pages for her math and phonics, she prefers to read on her own and do on her own, and then she brings them to me, and I check them, and we go over whatever we need to go over. I always look at the lesson if there's something that we haven't done before, like we haven't, this is the first time we've done how many hours. We'll do that together, and then she'll do her story problems on her own and counting by twos in her addition, since we've done that many times and she knows how to do that. So that's how we do our math, and that's Horizons. For like history and for science and a little bit of Bible, we do Little Hearts for His Glory. I had a friend recommend this to me, and I bought it. I went online and looked at it. I never held it in my hands before. I did look at it online, and I just bought it, and I've loved it. We really enjoy it. It has little boxes. That's how their curriculum works. You have boxes for everything, for each little subject. Now, they do recommend certain phonics and math curriculums, but I chose my own, so I just leave off those boxes. And there are other things that sometimes I leave off depending, you know, sometimes we don't do artistic expression or music or something like that, but we always do the reading about history, which normally includes a Bible story and a book, you know, here's history for little pilgrims, and it goes through kind of American history and that, and world history and that kind of thing. So that's what we do for history and for science. Now, if we are having a super busy day or something hasn't gone right or she's just having a rough day, this is the thing that goes. Like, this is the history and science is the thing that we will leave out on occasion if things just aren't going well. And that doesn't happen very often, but like today we were running errands all morning long, had doctor's appointment for Gwyneth, and I had to get groceries and pick up a few things for Mark. So we came home and we did our math and phonics and reading and Bible, and we left out the Little Hearts for His Glory. And that's just, you know, that's just life. That just happens. So that's what we do for history and science. Now, we always begin our school day at the very beginning before we do anything with our Bible verses. She does scripture memorization, and I just printed these off and laminated them. I mean, just simple little things I found. This is from BibleStoryPrintables.com, and they have lots of little books that you can print off and laminate and staple together for your kid, and it's all about scripture. And then our Little Hearts for His Glory, they have a scripture memorization each week to go along with each unit, and I just write them on paper, and I mean, I've even messed up things, and here's an example like that. I mean, I messed up. It's cheap. I don't really care. She doesn't care. She gets the point, and that's whole purpose is for her to hide his words in her heart. It's not for mommy to write perfectly. So we always start our day with the scripture. Then we move on to her phonics charts. Then we do our phonics lesson. Then she does her phonics workbook page. Then we do our math lesson and math workbook pages. Then we do Little Hearts for His Glory. Then I work with Liam, and I get supplemental pages off the internet at freehomeschoolingdeals.com. If you've never been there, you need to go there, because there's lots, she posts tons of like free packets and free things for homeschoolers to be able to use. And even if you're a school teacher, there's lots of great resources for your students as well. But we've been working on like ABC orders, so I'll have her do a couple of these. She does lots of addition practice, and so this is what she's been doing for the month of February, Valentine edition. Super easy stuff just to practice and sharpen her skills and get her quicker with certain skills that we've been working on. We do comprehension, reading comprehension, so she'll read, look at the picture, and then answer the questions. And we do that, and she does all these things while I'm working with Liam on his schoolwork, which does not take very long. It's not very intense. We just are working on numbers and letters and sounds, so nothing too intense for him. He's not even quite 4 yet. So then we always have an outside reading book for Ella, and she, I will read to her a chapter book. Like, this is one of the little books series that we read, and we're finished with this one and have moved on to another one, but it's just simple little chapters, quick. It just gets her to where she's doing reading something other than just a picture book, and she's listening and using her imagination instead of just staring at pictures when she reads. And then along with our phonics curriculum with the Abeka, you have different books that you read, and this is for the kiddos. And she will read one story to me in the morning, and then she'll read to her dad at night. And this is a book she read, or a story she read a couple weeks ago, The Big Day. And they've gotten to where fairly long, seem to take. And so she reads that to me. I hope you can see that. And I had a homeschooling friend, kind of a mentor, tell me that whenever she does reading like this with her kids, that when they stumble, like we work on sight words whenever she works on her outside reading books, and that's when I do sight word work. I don't do sight word flashcards or anything like that. We just practice them when she reads. And when we do this, this is strictly for fluency. Like, I want her to be quick, and I want her to have comprehension, and I just want her to be fluid. I don't want it to be choppy. And so I give her moments to work words out that she might have trouble with, but if she's really struggling, I just tell her words so she can learn what it's like to be confident and to have fluency and to not read choppy, because that affects their comprehension. And so that's what we do with that. That's just a little tip a mentor gave me. Not everybody has to do it like that, but it works for us, and she's been very successful with her reading. This spring semester, we've been reading out of the Child's Story Bible by Catherine Voss. And I just read a story a day. And this Bible is just, they're just stories from the Bible. There aren't pictures, a bunch of pictures to go along with it. I literally just read to them, and the two older kids sit and listen to it. We have another Bible that Mark reads in the evenings to the kids before we go to bed. And, but this is another way that we get the Bible into our schooling every single day. Ella does outside reading books, and she reads during her nap time. Well, during rest time, she doesn't nap anymore. And Mark always works with her on flashcards for math to just improve on her addition skills. Every evening during the week, he does that with her. So I feel like all the curriculums we picked out, I had to kind of pick and choose certain pieces that I felt like worked into our school day. And when I first started, there was a little bit of guilt, like, oh my, I'm not getting it all, and I'm not able to do it all. And you know what? I've just relaxed, and it's been such a blessing for us that we've just been able to kind of pick and choose what works, and we're still getting in a full day and a full curriculum, for every subject, and it's been working really well. So I hope that helped you guys. Confessionsofahomeschooler.com is another great resource for you moms starting out to get some printables and some extra supplemental tools to use during your school day. And Money Saving Mom is a homeschooler too. She gives, sometimes has on some packets that you can find online for free to download. So those are definitely some websites I would check out. I will link to all of the curriculum that we use. And I hope that you guys have had a successful year so far. If you've started, and if not, good luck. It's a lot of fun, and I hope that you enjoy picking out your curriculums. Thank you.